We're back at Wall's End today, getting down the sort of structure and whole production for a song called Always. It's been in the works for ages. I wrote it ages ago, but we're just getting around to kind of completing it now and getting it done as a song and a release that we're probably going to put on the EP. Well, not probably, we are. So this is the first little bits of getting Always down, a tune that you do not know at the moment, but I'm sure you will.
Like an old man with his beer, sitting in the back room bar, feeling younger with the time. I've been thinking about things too much lately. It's driving my worried mind.
It's really cool to just be getting the bass down of songs that I've written on the acoustic guitar and sort of building them from the acoustic guitar up, getting some lead down and stuff, and just sort of building out the songs as really solid demos. And then the idea is to have a big backlog of music that we can pick from. But I mean, it's been really, really cool. You can hear sirens. You can hear the constant sirens of Wall's End. Kind of sets the... Oh, and a fire engine. Is that an ambulance as well?
You up that Sunday, I didn't mean to change your mind. I've been wide awake all night, just trying to leave this all behind. The city seems to haunt me from the last time that we met. How I gave you every reason to forgive but not forget.
Let's stay away from that. That's like
that was mint.
Yeah. I reckon that start with that.
But it's like one guitar part where you're like it could just be that and it's massive. Like that.
Yeah. Keep that. Do that again.
One, two, three, four.
Can you do the do 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 do?
Yeah. Oh, my God. I think it. Oh, yeah, because we have the octave on. But this is cooler, coming up with one part.
Is there an octave thing?
But rather than doing that, which that's what makes it indie five for me. Yeah, when you're putting your own bass in.
Yeah.
That one. It's like a riff. I do like that, man.
I like that. Do the bed one. We've arrived at Cafe Indie. Just heading in there now to sound check and set up, load in. I'll show you guys coming in the back entrance now. Really looking forward to tonight. It's going to be a good one, I think. I'll have to get a ticket count in a bit, but it's only a small venue. So I'm hoping it looks good regardless. Come on, boys.
Yeah.
Show me.
Write your standards.
Yeah. Getting the sound check done for later on. You'll probably see a lot of these, especially as the gigs get more and more frequent as well. So far this year we've only had, it's been a bit of gaps between gigs and stuff. Single time I've done a video for the vlog this month. Promise I have another jacket.
Who doesn't?
Back in Wall's End.
Thank you.
just managed to put down some extra sort of electric parts for the ballady type song with a harmony guitar that belonged to my granddad that he got from a market in Libya in about 1973, I think. I'm just, it's a bit crazy, intonation's off, but we managed it, didn't we?
Yeah.
Kind of cool that we managed to get a little hollow body on the track and make it sound as it sounded. You'll hear it at some point anyway, but pretty crazy.
Take the pain away. I'll be the sunshine on a rainy day, the warmth to keep the blues away. It's true, I'll always love you.
Well, April is well underway. It's been release month for Stay Right Till The End, so thank you to everyone who's been streaming my latest single, sharing it, adding it to your playlist. I can't tell you how much it means. It may seem like a really small thing, you know, for you guys to just be adding it to your playlist, but then in abundance it makes a hell of a difference, so thank you very much. Or to everyone's kind words as well. Every single song I've been releasing has kind of just been smashing the previous one out of the park in regards with growth and streams and everything, so it's been amazing. We actually released the music video as well that I showed a little bit of behind the scenes for in the last vlog in March. And that's on 10,000 views now. It's, you know, it's coming up to just over a week and a half after release, which is amazing. And yeah, what else? Found out recently I've been shortlisted to the final to support James Arthur at the Riverside Stadium, which is mad. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'll put the poster up there now so you guys can see. I'll be playing the Teesside Student Union, so the Teesside Hub, on the 7th of June, which is technically, well, it is the night before the gig, and then James Arthur will be down himself. It'll be me, three other artists, we'll be battling it out, and he'll be picking, you know, one of us to support him at the Riverside Stadium the following night. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I know I went on in the last one with Glastonbury and everything, how much we have to kind of participate in these kind of things so early on and battle it out, but it's part of it. You just got to learn to enjoy it and do as much as you possibly can. And I feel truly grateful to have been, you know, selected down to the last four out of God knows how many people, you know, applied in the first place. And it's going to be amazing doing it in my hometown, the Teesside Student Union. I've had amazing messages, a really great response to that. So really looking forward to it. And then got fully confirmed is Rag and Bone Man. I'll be supporting Rag and Bone Man at Lisa's Park in the Park Festival on the 5th of May. That's just been confirmed. I'll put a post up for that now. Yeah, boy! Amazing gig. I remember looking at these gigs, you know, a couple of years ago and just thinking, wow, what an amazing lineup. Imagine being a part of. Imagine getting to be a part of a lineup like that. And I always thought, you know, I kind of knew we were working towards it, but it feels amazing to be in the situation now where we're, you know, my name's been put on posters like this and we've been trusted as acts and clearly been sought out and recognised to be able to put on a good show and be on these bills is really good. Hopefully the first of many, because like I said, you know, there's no agent involved with me at the moment. It's I've got a really small team of my manager and stuff, and yeah, it's gonna be good. It makes me more excited to kind of think how things are gonna be when, you know, the team expands and a live agent does get involved and we can start really getting out there properly. Because if you think what we're kind of doing so far without that is, you know, it's very difficult to do, but I'm really grateful and can't wait for that. Can't wait to show you guys on May's vlog as well. I can't believe it's May already. But yeah, other than that, just checking in, telling you guys what's going on. You know, it's been, these vlogs seem a bit mental when I watch them back and kind of check them out, but it's kind of mad to think that each month has kind of been quiet for me, really. Because I've, you know, the gigs have been far between. And we've kind of been gearing up for things behind the scenes. We've been in the studio a lot. I've been writing a ton more. I think what I'm more excited about more than anything this year so far and going forward is, you know, all the new stuff that we've been coming up with. Because no one's heard any of it yet. And yeah, it's going to be, it's going to be an exciting 6 months, let me tell you that, when we start moving on to the next load of new songs. So yeah, just checking in. Thank you for checking out the new single anyway, all you guys who have. So I've just landed in Wrexham for an acoustic gig, solo acoustic gig supporting Carl Falconer tonight. Thought I'd get the train. He got run over by a bus. That'd have been a great start. Thought I'd get the train just to save myself driving, because I can't really be bothered. I mean, when it's solo acoustic, there's no gear apart from my guitar, which is like really, really nice sometimes. I'm just wandering to the venue now, meet Kev, and then he's gonna head down to the hotel, get checked in, and it should be a good one. It's like a home from home in Wrexham. I've played here about five or six times, I think. I think this might be my sixth or seventh time of playing, which is mad, because it's just quite random. It's in Wales, but it's always just been mint. Great people, great vibe, great venue. I mean, what more can you want? Right, we have arrived at Middlesbrough Town Hall today, and we're shooting a music video for an upcoming song that I'm really excited about. It's got two locations. First one is here, and I won't give too much away, but it's not a performance style one. We'll be we'll be using this here table. It's mad being back here because I just remember being the first time I was here on this stage anyway. I was in a school choir in year 11 singing Africa by Toto. And we came out of that door up there, down some steps, and there was just all the platforms there and we all stood on. So, and I've been back since, doing a hometown headline show last year downstairs. And then I think ultimately a big goal will be to come and do this room. So maybe if anyone's watching this now, it's April. It's going to get really dark, sorry. If anyone's watching this now, it's April 2024. And we're currently here for the music video. And I can maybe snap my fingers and then it'll be when I'm headlining it.
There's Travis Bickle.
But yeah, looking forward to today. We're starting off here and then we're heading to Low Force. Which is like a kind of really cool spot. Lots of little river kind of thing, lots of little pools. Because I had the great idea of jumping in just as part of the video, because I just get these crazy ideas. Sounded like a great idea, and then found out that it's 4 degrees. And windy and meant to rain. So yeah. I'll catch up with you later on.
Somewhere, again, we're just thinking on our feet, really.
Oh, nice. Win, lose, life, death, reward, risk. I like it.
Yeah. We think not to go too much busier than this because when we're playing...
Just wrapped up. Well, that's good lighting. Just wrapped up at Middlesbrough Town Hall for the video today. I'm going to show you a couple of bits. Without giving too much away, because you know we've been getting a lot of behind the scenes stuff. We've been getting everything sort of ready to be put together for the video. But I know this will probably be the first you've seen of it, of mine. I'm looking forward to you guys seeing the process, seeing what goes on. And yeah, it's been a mint day. We've had everyone down, and. We've just got behind the scenes of behind the scenes, haven't we, really? Yeah, we have, yeah. And I'm going to Low Force later on, which I think will probably be the highlight of the entire vlog in April. I had this cool idea of maybe jumping into some water to kind of signify taking a leap or something. It sounds really pretentious when I say it like that, but literally these are just ideas that pop in my head. But yeah, I'll be doing that later on. I'll show you guys that. Because I guess it'll be quite a cool sneak preview of what's coming. But yeah, that is kind of a wrap on the Grey Skies official video at Middlesbrough Town Hall.
Oh, look at that. Hello, little guy. Hello.
So going back a few months, I had this. That was a sheep that made that noise. Going back a few months, I had this idea for music video to, you know, be jumping into some form of body of water, and it seemed like a mint idea. And now the day has arrived. And it's like the sun's came out, which is quite nice, but then I've just put my arm in the water I'm jumping into, and my hand knacked after like 4 minutes.
It's like, you know, when it's that cold, it hurts your skin.
Quality, mate.
I put my hand in for 5 seconds and it knacks. Then I'm going to go fully in. My
you know, when it's that cold that it hurts. so and I mean, yeah, I'm not really looking forward to it.
Doesn't say anything about no jumping in for music videos, but we'll welcome a low force.
Gonna test the depth of that water.
I don't know about, it's very, very deep there, but I don't know, I hope there's no undercurrent or anything like that.
Little injury. The danger's on set.
Another month and another song coming up now. For anyone just joining on these vlogs, I like to finish every vlog with a song that I've been writing or coming up with. It has to be from that month as well, so this is from April. You're gonna get plenty more of this because as you'll have seen in the vlog with Billy and Matt and Rob and stuff, we've been getting well underway with sort of drafting out lots of new music and getting a big backlog of stuff. So yeah, it's gonna be mint just to be converting, you know, all these songs that start on an acoustic guitar into, you know, single worthy stuff, hopefully, with a lot of them. And yeah, I thought I'd give you this little rendition I've got here. It's a bit of a nightmare this month because I came up with this condition a while ago called wacky mouth, which is dry skin here, which is I never used to get, but I've recently started getting. I call it wacky mouth because the only people who get it are usually kids who go to the wacky warehouse. Oh god. So yeah, I think my goal for May is to maybe moisturize a little bit more. But yeah, this one's called burning bridge.
Called you up that Sunday, I didn't mean to change your mind. I've been wide awake all night, just trying to leave this all behind. The city seems to haunt me from the last time. between being how I give you every reason to forgive but not forgive.
So far, see you in the next one.